you guys, welcome back to my channel. Can you believe, of course you can believe it, but can you believe that July is over? We're more than halfway through to 2016. I don't even know what year it is yet, by the way. It's 2016 and I can't believe that time has flown by so fast. I'm a year older. That sucks. Anyway, but a new month means that I have a whole new set of monthly favorites. So let's quickly get started with this month, alright? I'm going to start off with some makeup favorites because I understand that a lot of you are here mostly because you're interested in that. So the first makeup favorite that I had all through the month of July is my Rimmel Lasting Finish 25-Hour Foundation. Now, you guys have probably already seen my review of this, but if you haven't, then I'll link it up here. The fact remains that I absolutely love this foundation. It's the one that I'm wearing today. It's thick in consistency and its packaging is horrible, but the coverage is beautiful and it's very comfortable to wear. I wear it on a daily basis now that I have very severe acne and I'm very into not having that show up too much. So I love this foundation. Easy to blend. Highish coverage, definitely medium high coverage, and it's a wonderful foundation. The next makeup favorite I have is a blush, and this is the Wet n Wild Color Icon Ombre Blush in the shade The Princess Daiquiris. I just have nothing bad to say about this blush at all. I mean, this is the one that I'm wearing today, and it's a very nice pinky but natural blush. It has a slight bit of sheen to it, but nothing overbearing. I guess the one con I could say is that it's a little powdery, but I've learned to work with it and I have learned to love it. This is the only blush that I have been reaching out for this entire month. In fact, when I was in the States and I didn't upload a monthly favorite for June, I was still wearing just this, and I have really been loving it, and there's a good chance that you might see this in next month's favorite as well because I have not been able to put it down. The next makeup favorite is another purchase that I made in the US, and it is the Hard Candy Glow All The Way Bronzer in the shade Tiki. Now, this is again the highlight that I'm wearing today. It's called a bronzer, but it is definitely a highlight, and it's the highlight that I'm wearing today. I hope that you can see it. It's natural. At the same time, it doesn't skimp out on the sheen. It looks beautiful, but I can totally pass this off as a natural glow from within. The last powder product is the Revlon Vivid Baked Bronzer. Pardon me, mine looks completely ratchet because I have messed up the packaging. But nonetheless, this is a very beautiful bronzer. I do want to sort of swatch it out for you. As you can see, it's a very warm tone, kind of orangey shimmery bronzer, and surprisingly how I like to use it is after I've contoured my cheeks, I take this on a large fluffy brush and I just go over my contour and all around the perimeters of my face, and again it gives me a nice glow. It makes me look just a little bronzy but not too much. It gives me a nice tan, I suppose you can say that, and it works as a wonderful way to blend out a contour if I have applied too much, and I have really been enjoying this. It has, if you guys remember, I won an Instagram Sephora launch thing a while ago when the Sephora in Noida launched, and as a part of my prize I got a gift hamper inside which I found a Sephora liquid liner. This teeny tiny little tube is absolutely magic for me because it gives me a nice, very crisp, very matte and very black line. The applicator is not very flimsy. It definitely is a little on the harder side, but that gives me a very controlled kind of application, and I have really been loving it. It lasts all day, however long that I want it to last, even in the summer heat of Delhi, but at the same time it's not exactly hard to wash off, and I find that a blessing, sometimes in disguise, but definitely a blessing, because at the end of the day I don't want to spend 20 minutes, 30 minutes to an hour to remove my eyeliner. Sometimes that can be a problem with gel eyeliners, and this one just comes off really easily and it makes life very easy for me. The next eye makeup item that I have really enjoyed has been this one. This is the Wet n Wild Color Icon Nude Eyeliner. It really does help, you know, make your eyes look larger, wider, more open. and I really have enjoyed it. It's such a long pencil that I feel like you get a lot of product, and it was really, really cheap. I think it was less than $1, maybe $1. So if you guys can go to America, or if you have somebody visiting, this is another item that I really strongly suggest that you pick up. Another eye makeup product that I have been loving is something that I have told you about a million times, and it is the CoverGirl Supersizer Mascara. It's washable. I love that. I have really been enjoying washable eye makeup products because they just come off so easily, and it's like really beautiful in the sense that it just elongates and volumizes and overall gives me a very dramatic kind of look on my eyelashes. It's the one that I'm wearing today. It has been the one that I've been wearing almost all my videos, and it's beautiful. I love it. Okay, a few lip products are the Revlon Super Lustrous Lipsticks. I have two of them over here. The one is in the shade Wink for Pink, and it's a cream shade. It's a cream formula. And the other one is called Pink Cognito, and it's a shine formula. I think you can find these here in India, but again, I'm not really sure. You can find other shades, and really more than the shades, it's the formula that I have been really enjoying. I think I can apply a little bit more. It's the formula that I have really been enjoying. It's so comfortable to wear, it's so quick to apply, and it's really, really, really wonderful. I mean, I know that the world is all about matte lipsticks right now, but I'm a little bit over them at the moment because they do dry my lips out extremely badly. And this is just so comfortable. If you can find these lipsticks, I know you can. I really do recommend them. It doesn't matter what color you're buying. It's the formula. It's wonderful. You should go and try it out. Let's quickly move on to a little bit of skincare. Now, the first bit of skincare that I have been loving has been my EOS lip balms. This is the one in, I think, coconut milk, and I think that's what it's called, and I have really, really been loving it. It has kept my lips from being their usual dry, chapped cells, and I cannot thank it enough. In 1 month, I have used it this much. So clearly, it's going to be empty really soon, and I'm going to be doing a DIY EOS lip balm really soon, but till the time comes, it's wonderful. If I know that it is available in India, I will link a site where you can buy this particular scent also, because the scent is to die for. I love that coconutty kind of really, really delicious smell. So I'm going to link this exact product if I can find it in the description box. If you want to buy it, it's available to buy. As much as I love some real good makeup that does its job well and, you know, makes me look all pretty and everything, I also really love when my makeup can come off well. And for that, I believe investing in a good makeup remover is absolutely essential. The makeup remover that I have been loving is the Garnier Micellar Water. This is the one that removes waterproof makeup as well, and I have really, really, truly been enjoying it. In a span of 2 months, I've only managed to use this much, and I not only use it for my eyes and lips, but I also sometimes use it to remove my entire face makeup, and it does a wonderful job. I have been loving it. Not this exact variant, but I have found other variants that you can purchase in India, and again, I will link them in the description box. After removing your makeup, it is absolutely essential to also remove any remains of the makeup and of the makeup remover that you might have on your face. And for that, I have been loving these two products, again from my American haul. Pardon me, I have a lot of new American makeup and I have really enjoyed it. The first thing is this face wash. It's the Olay Oil Minimizing Clean Foaming Cleanser. And surprisingly, anything that says oil minimizing, I tend to believe it's going to really dry out my skin and strip it of its, you know, natural oils and make me really uncomfortable. But surprisingly, this one does not. And what's even more surprising is that it is not even soap free. It definitely has soap in it. So I still expected it to completely just strip my skin dry and make me like really uncomfortable, but this doesn't, and I'm so pleasantly surprised with it. It's not available in India, even though this is a huge, huge tube. When I do run out of it, I'm going to feel really bad because I have not used any face wash that has made me as happy as this one has. It really makes you squeaky clean, but just no no dryness or, you know, stripped skin at all. It's amazing. I have been using another new tool for washing my face, and it is my trusty Muh Dhone Ki Machine, the Olay Pro X Cleansing System. This again is not available in India, but I'm generally in love with this concept. I know that Oriflame makes one, and Clarisonic and Sonic Clear, and there are lots and lots and lots of companies to make it here, and there are various that are easily available. This is just the one that I own, and it's not so much this particular brand that I'm loving, but the concept of having a spinning cleanser to cleanse your skin very deeply and properly. Moving on to some actual skincare, I recently purchased a new sunscreen, and I was very surprised to find that I love it. This is the Lotus Safe Sun UV Matte Gel PA Triple Plus SPF 50. Now, this is a gel format, and I bought that very consciously, thinking that maybe it's not going to clog my pores and it's going to give me a nice matte base for my foundation and all of that. And yeah, it does all of that. One of the best things about it is that when I wash my face or anything, it doesn't leave white streakies on my face. That's just not cute. So it really has been a very good SPF, but surprisingly, not only has it been very comfortable to apply on my face, I have used this on my arms, my legs, neck, everywhere, and it has not felt uncomfortable even on my arms. As in, I know it's a gel formula, but it is still plenty moisturizing even for my body. So I was very surprised to find that I really do like it. It's a wonderful, wonderful thing. It's not very expensive. It was for like 395 rupees. Oh, by the way, all the products that I mentioned, I will have all their prices, even if they are in dollars, mentioned in the description box. One of you wonderful people did mention that I should tell you the prices of products, even if they're not available in India, because maybe somebody is going out and they want to buy it and they want to like plan out their budget like that. So I will mention all the prices, even if those prices are only in dollars, in the description box. Talking about body moisturizers, I mentioned this in my haul, but I have really enjoyed using the Suave Skin Solutions Advanced Therapy. Now, this is more of a monthly favorite for June than it is for July, because ever since I've been back, I've only used it twice. Over here, my skin thankfully is not as dry as it was in the States. But nonetheless, this is a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful moisturizer. It smells delicious. It has a nice, very, very clean kind of citrusy smell. And I've really enjoyed it. In those 2 months, I've used up this much. I can see it against my lighting. I've used up this much, and that's quite a lot because this is a humongous bottle. Keeping within the brand, I have also really enjoyed using the Suave conditioner. It smells like peaches. You get a ginormous amount, and by the way, I deep condition my hair because I have such crazy frizzy, you know, really bad hair. They're really fine, so they get static and they get frizzy all the time. They're not like heavier, thicker, coarser hair. Sometimes I wish they were, but they're not. They're just really frizzy. So every time I wash my hair, I legit deep condition them. And this is what I've been using. I've used this for 2 months and I've only used this much, which just says a lot. It's a humongous amount of product, and I really do enjoy it. It's wonderful, it smells wonderful, it's a great conditioner. And you know what, I've never actually heard any American YouTuber talk about this Suave brand, but I don't know why, because I just happened to pick it up because this was the cheapest one over there, and I love it. I really love it. Keeping within the realm of hair, I have really enjoyed using the Batiste dry shampoo. This is the one which has a little bit of tint to it in the shade brown, and it has really been a game changer for me, because third day hair usually means grease ball, which is stuck till here and really fluffy and frizzy here, and it's not a cute look. But this really has helped me. I use this, I don't use it as liberally as say somebody in America would, because this isn't that much a part of my routine yet, but considering that I would normally wash my hair every other day, this has really saved my hair from being stripped by a shampoo by at least 1 to 2 days sometimes, and I love that. I love that it doesn't have an offensive smell. I'm not going to say it's a good smell, but the smell is not offensive at all. And because it is tinted, I don't have to worry about a white cast, and I really do love it. This is This is very quickly becoming a hair care essential for me because it's just so good. And finally, to a last product, this is a fragrance. I think I mentioned in my haul, but Victoria's Secret had a semi-annual sale while I was there, and I got one of their fragrances. This is the Hypnotized Fragrance Mist for $5, and I have been using it quite a lot. I know you can't tell because it's only till here, but I have been using this quite a lot, and it has a delicious kind of sweet fruity scent. I love it, and I have been wearing this exclusively, and I'm not a girl who wears a lot of perfume. I only wear perfume for special occasions, but this I have been throwing on just mindlessly because this smells so good. It smells so good. With that, I finished my monthly favorites for the month of July 2016. Tell me if any of these products have been your favorites, and if not, what have been your favorites? Please mention that in the comments below, and maybe I'd like to check those out. Also, while you're at it, do give this video a big thumbs up, please. It'll make me really, really happy. And subscribe to join the YouTube family. I would love to have you part of my family. I hope you're having a great day, and I will see you next time. Bye.